टुडेज टॉपिक इज C++ प्रोग्राम टू रिवर्स एन एरे यूजिंग इटरेटिव मेथड। सो लेट गेट स्टार्टेड। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर यूजिंग टर्बो C++। तो फर्स्ट ओपन दिस एप्लीकेशन। फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट बाय इंक्लूडिंग हैज इंक्लूड stdio.h। वी इंक्लूड द stdio एंड कोनी पैकेज। आफ्टर दैट वी क्रिएट अ वॉइड मेन मेथड विच इज द एंट्री पॉइंट ऑफ आवर प्रोग्राम। Inside the main method, call a function which is clrscr, which its work is to clear the screen. Then we create a integer array and assign the value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. After that, we create another integer variable which stores the size of the array. In this case, it is 6. Create a reverse function which take array as an argument and a size and reverse the array. So we create a function which syntax is void, means it doesn't return anything, and the name of the function in this case is reverse array, and with parentheses we create an int array and int n as an argument. Inside the reverse array, we create two variable of integer type. First, which store the first index or 0, and second is the last index, which store the n-1. And after that we create a loop which run until star is less than end. Inside the loop, we create a temp variable which store the temp value as array's first value. After that, we assign the array start to the array end, and array end is equal to temp. After that, we increase the start and decrease the end. We come outside the function and create another function which is print array. It takes array and array size and print it. So inside the print array function, we create a loop which run from starting 0 to array to then array's length, and inside the loop we create a print statement which print the value of array every time the loop runs. Now we will come back in our main method, and here we create first a print statement which just print a text that array before reverse. And after that, we call our print array method by passing the array and its size. After that, we create another print statement which print a statement of array after reverse. Then after that, we call our reverse statement. After that, we call our reverse method by passing again array and its size. After that, we again call our print array statement to print the reverse array. Then we call a getch method to hold our output screen. Now here the program, how it's look like. I think I have typed the wrong array name. Then we go to our run menu and click on run button. The output screen shown